الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد. It's important for us to realize that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves someone and is pleased with someone, that of course this is the best, you're in the best of states. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is displeased with someone, they are the sharru bariya. They are the worst of creatures. And we should look at these differences that we find between the various groups, sects, and individuals and callers. We should look at them on the scale of Islam. For example, the Sunni Shia controversy. What's behind this? We have a group of people on one hand who say the Sahaba are beloved and that they are trustworthy and that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam chose them and loved them and said that the people who hate them are hypocrites. This is what we have the Sunnis claiming. Let's see what the Shia and their various sects with their various different creeds, but generally we find that many of them, not all of them, but many of them unite and hold as a fundamental principle in their creed the belief that the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam were not trustworthy, that they did not preserve the Sharia, that they lied and cheated, and that they are in fact non-Muslim. This is what many of the Rafidiyya, the 12 Imam, the Shias who believe in this, and many of these other sects of Shia, they hold that this principle that the Sahaba were not trustworthy, and that they should be considered hypocrites, they should be cursed, and so forth. This is a fundamental principle of their religion, and investigate it for yourself. Now, let's see if we can judge between these two opposite paradigms. These are contradicting paradigms. These are two opposite views and ideologies, in fact, which contradict one another. So how do we make a judgment between this? Let's go back to the Quran. In kuntum sadiqin, if you're truly a believer in Allah, then you'll go back to the Quran. What does Allah say about these individuals we call the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in? Qala ta'ala fi kitabihi al-kareem was-sabiqun al-awwalun min al-muhajirin wal-ansar walladhina i'tabaruhum bi-ihsan radiyallahu anhum wa radu anhu وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِيَ الْأَنْهَارِ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. This is what Allah says to just get rid of this whole dispute. Let's just squash this. Here's what Allah the Almighty said. Allah the Almighty and Majestic said, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, the Sabiqun, meaning those who preceded, those who came before, and those who also race towards goodness. وَسَابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ, the first. مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifies for us. Who are these سَابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ? Who are these ones Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about? He said the Muhajireen. Who are the Muhajireen? Those are the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those are the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were known as the Muhajireen. There's no other tafsir for that one. There's no other way that you can look and get away from the Arabic language and fall into any kind of traps and distort what Allah said when He was referring to the Muhajireen. Those people who made hijrah. What is hijrah? Those people who immigrated. Who were they? They were immigrated from Mecca to Medina. Medina to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Muhajireen wal Ansar. Who are the Ansar? Those are the people who accepted them in Medina. Who are they? They're the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَسَابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنْصَارِ. I didn't say it. This guy didn't say it. Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala said it. He said, وَالَّذِينَ اعْتَبَرُوا بِإِحْسَانٍ, and those who follow them in righteousness. So Allah is telling us something about these, those people who preceded us, and preceded us in goodness, and that they were the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and those who follow them in righteousness. Allah said it. What did He say? وَالَّذِينَ اَعْتَبَرُهُمْ بِيَسَانِ, and those who follow them in good. Allah said it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, said it. بِيَسَانِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَلَى عَنْهُمْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ. Allah said, and Allah is pleased with them. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ. Allah is pleased with them. So you don't have any choice if you believe in Islam but to be pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His commands, the Quran, and to be pleased with the commands of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to be pleased with the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them all, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them all with Jannatul Firdaws. Ameen. That squashes your argument. Stay away from that. That man is anyone who tells you about the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, anybody who speaks ill about them, walk away from them. Avoid them at all costs. We don't care if they're, whatever their name is, if they call themselves Muslim. And again, if they call themselves Muslim, we don't care. Because they have destroyed the principles of Islam. The people who carried Islam to, and Allah preserved the religion through them, was the Sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let's go back to the ayah when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and those who follow them in righteousness, Allah is pleased with them. Allah said it in the Quran. This is Surah At-Tawbah, verse 100. Allah said, Allah is pleased with them. وَرَضِيُ عَنْهُ. And they are pleased with Him. They're pleased with Allah. They are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were pleased with Allah. And those who follow them are righteous, the Salaf as-Salih, they're pleased with Allah and the commands of Allah. All the way up until the Day of Judgment, meaning those people from amongst our time even, in 2012, that those people who are pleased with the commands of Allah and love the Sahaba of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and pleased with what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with, those people are the believers. Those are the people Allah are pleased with. Because they're pleased with Allah and His command. So Allah said, then Allah tells us what He's planned and prepared for them. Allah says, and He has prepared, or He has prepared for them. Allah said, He has prepared for them, جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِ مِنْ تَحْتِيَ الْأَنْهَارِ. He has prepared for them gardens under which rivers flow. And خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, they will be in it forever. Meaning they'll be in the paradise, in the most beautiful state, in the most beautiful place forever. أَبَدًا خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا ذَلِكَ فَوْزُ عَظِيمٌ. Allah says, and that is the great success. عَظِيمٌ, the best, the most successful. It's not through wealth. It's not through how much property. It's not through how many partners that you've had in this life, or whatever you strove to attain in this life. But it's gaining paradise and having Allah pleased with you. It's not just that you love Allah, as the ulama always state, but it's that Allah loves you. You have to ask yourself that. That's what we want. We want Allah to love us. We want Allah to forgive us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this to be khalisan li wajhihi al-kareem. May Allah bless us to be for His sake. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to love Him as He loves to be loved and praised. And may Allah bless us to have iman increased in our hearts, loving the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. May Allah be pleased with all of them and bless them all with Jannatul Firdaws, the highest level of Jannah. And may Allah bless us to be of those who are companions of theirs in Jannatul Firdaws. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And may Allah help the Muslimin everywhere. And may Allah forgive us of all of our sins and all of our shortcomings. Anything I said that was correct was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. And may Allah tabaraka ta'ala bless the Muslimin in Syria. May Allah grant them relief and success in this life as well as the hereafter. And may Allah preserve them, those that are living, from the evil of the Zalimeen, those evil oppressors, those wicked shayateen, from the Shia, from the wicked oppressors, those those communist Baathist people. May Allah protect us from their evil, and may Allah wipe them off the earth and replace them with Ahl Sunnah, ruling by the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wa sallallahu alaihi wasallam ala Nabiyyina Muhammad.